Surely they wouldn't allow such lawlessness amongst their ranks.
I would imagine they are unaware of it. Most of the army has fallen back to the capital and hunkered down behind her walls. Those who weren't recalled now rule the fringes unchecked, answering to no one but themselves.
Then it's worse than we imagined. You should return to Rosaria. It's not safe here.
I'll find a caravan heading north. You won't mind if I borrow one of these soldiers' coin purses?
Not at all. Now, to find this second associate of Rutherford's. If he was bound for Oriflam, I'll start at Northreach and see if I can pick up his trail.
Everything's back the way it was.
Fresh silks from the camp.
Must have. Mandrake saffron.
If there's one thing we've learned over the past few moons, is that we're stronger when we... together. And if having a mare can help us do that, I'm all for it.
Deserve a rest. Good girl. That must be the camp Victor mentioned.
We make this quick.
That's him! The one that killed Doc and Fingers! Take his head off!
I'd better let Victor know.
Sid, where are you? Ah, I see the bandits didn't pose you any trouble.
No, but that's not why you're here, is it?
No. Something's happened. We need you back in Dalimil.
What is it?
The whole town's in uproar. They're saying that Lubor is a bearer.
What?
Seems that one of our parties wasn't as thorough as they should have been. They let one of the bandits escape, and his escape route took him right through Dalimil. Some of the children spotted him, and he was about to silence them. And when Lubor felled him with a bolt of magic, and without a crystal.
But that's not possible.
It is, if he's a bearer and has been hiding it all these years, which is what people are saying. If he has, well, I wouldn't blame him. No man is branded by choice. Still, all those people see is a man who's lied to them all his life. One who was made a leader of himself when the world believed he should have been a slave.
Fuck.
I don't know where we go from here, but I know one thing. Lubor needs all the friends he can get right now.
You're right.
And now everyone knows. I made it a habit to keep a crystal close at hand for just such an occasion. And when that occasion arose, I forgot to reach for it. Well, it was bound to come out sooner or later.
We're sorry, Lubor. We tried to keep running.
But we just couldn't anymore.
There's nothing to be sorry for. I rather enjoyed playing the hero for once. All that matters to me is that you two are safe.
Look at him talking to his betters like it's nothing.
All lies, I'll wager. Just like the ones he fed us all these years.
Once people make up their minds, it's hard to change them. We need to do something. And quickly. Convince the people not to let their prejudices blind them. Convince them that nothing has changed. That their enemy lies outside these walls, not within them.
You're right. We should speak to everyone.
I'm glad you agree. I'll handle the townsfolk. I'm a Dalmec born and bred. They listen to me. You head to the tavern. make Conrad and Natalie remember who Lubor really is. They know that Lubor and I are friends. I might not make for the most impartial of interlocutors. Lord Underhill of Randalar's League of Merchants, however, is a trusted and impartial mediator of note.
I'll do what I can. Lubor, stay here with the children. I can't promise anything, but we'll try.
And that is all I can ask of you.
None of the stalls were planted this time. Thanks, Peter Gilbert. How did your men fare? Why are you taking the bearer's side?
Why do they always have to make such a fuss?
He knew all along that he was...
Forgive me for disturbing you, but... could I have a moment of your time?
I've seen your face before.
As have I, Lord Underhill, wasn't it? Of the League of Merchants.
That's right. I wanted to speak to you about Lubor.
The rumors that he's a bearer. All true, I'm afraid.
He'll never be mayor now. Not if I have anything to do with it.
But what of his wares? Bearer or no, his steel is highly valued throughout the Republic. In this, at least, he's done the town a service. Might that not earn him a little leniency?
Leniency? He pretended to be one of us when he was laughing behind our backs all the while.
I'm sorry, my lord, but he lied to us. He lied to you. He cannot be trusted.
So what do you propose? Will you drive him from his home? Close his forge?
Perhaps. That is a question for the people of Dalimil, and they will thank you not to get involved.
The townsfolk have made their minds up. There was nothing I could do.
Nor I. Conrad and Natalie refused to consider anything but their own wounded pride.
You never know. Once their anger is cooled, they might see things differently. For now, we should report back to Lubor.
All right.
Why do they always have to make such a fuss outside? It's driving away our customers.
Lubor has been lying to us from the beginning.
You may have your business interests to consider, my lord.
Why the hell would Victor take the bearer's side?
Go on, Cid. No sense stalling. Lubor.
I assume the situation is hopeless?
There's still hope. But...
but perhaps not in this lifetime, I think it's fair to say.
You mustn't think like that, Lubor. Give them time. They'll come around. We'll talk some sense into them in the end, you'll see.
No, you won't. And your efforts would be better spent elsewhere.
But Lubor...
Rosina would often tell me... that steel does not lie. that a blade is a reflection of the smith who forged it. To yourself be true, that was her point. Rather an ironic one when you consider that her life was taken with a blade of her own making. But I do not doubt that she was always true to herself and what she believed in, right to the end. And so must I be. I must do what I know to be right, no matter what others might think of me. And now, I know what that is. I must embrace my new role of villain so that the people of Dalamil have something to unite against. For only united can they hope to stand against the threat that awaits them. I'll need to make a suitably dramatic exit, of course.
Don't go, Lubor. You're the only one who was ever kind to us.
We'll be all alone. Again.
Trust me, little ones. It is for the best that I go. Not only for the town, but for you, too.
How could it possibly be for the best? These children need you. The least you can do is give the townspeople a chance to change their minds.
They would not take it, Victor. It's over.
Over, you say? And so just like that, you're going to throw this town and these children to the wolves? I thought you were better than this, but it seems you had me fooled as well.
Victor.
Forget it. Do what you will.
Are you sure you're making the right choice, Lubor?
Of those available to me, I believe it's the best one. Yes. Ah, but where are my manners? Here, your reward for clearing out that bandit camp. Right then, I have packing to do.
If there's anything I can do, anything,
I'll bear it in mind. Thank you.
To Lubor.
I'm going to go with him.
The bearer of the burning quill is within, my lord. Prithee enter.
Lord Rosfield, is there aught the Undying might assist you with this day?
Perhaps. My brother said that your order was helping him with his quest to uncover Ultima's origins. Have you learned anything of note since last we spoke?
Little unless I regret to report.
I see.
Be assured, however, that we will not rest until the truth is known. Even now, our archaeologians scour ruins in every corner of the realm for traces of Ultima's touch.
Fallen ruins, I take it. Dating back as far as Phoenix Gate.
Indeed. Ultima's thralls are oft sighted among the remnants of the fallen civilization. As if protecting the secrets concealed within.
Secrets we'd see unearthed.
Should our methods be of interest, my lord, mayhap it would please you to observe some of our number at work.
Would that be possible?
Of course. A survey is being conducted not far from here. Perchance you are familiar with Kretov, a small hamlet built around a fallen airship. I was due to visit my colleagues there to collect their preliminary findings, but if you would consent to do so in my stead, I'm sure that they would be honored to relate any discoveries they have made to you directly.
All right. I'll go and meet with them.
They will be most gratified, I am sure. Might I suggest you take the road through Titan's Wake? It will lead you straight to the village after but a short walk.
Thank you. I will.
I wish you a safe journey, my lord. May the Firebird's flames burn ever in your heart.
The greater number of our order live among the masses, hidden in plain sight. Even here in Tabor, our brothers and sisters...
It's kind of you to take an interest in the Undying's affairs, brother.
I can't have you all keeping secrets from me, can I?
This is the Requietary, an archive where we have blown down and collect
complaints. The Undying are not the only secret fellowship in this realm, you know. There are others, each working for their own ends.
You wouldn't happen to have a decent whetstone in there, would you, madam?
I'm sure I can find you something. All of these stones have a good bit of diamond dust in them. That'll see your sword sharp, all right.
So it's these stones to Canva, and the rest of the boxes to Dalaman.
Those new boots treating you?
If it wasn't for those domed roofs protecting the stones from the elements, the truth of Tabor's history would have been lost centuries ago.
Careful how you pack that leather. Any creases or scratches will bring down the price.
Thank you for the deer leg, mister. Mummy made a pottage for it. Go inside if you want, but stay quiet.
These aren't ready for sale, if that's what you're thinking. And I'll thank you to keep your hands to yourself.
Fortune in skin and scale awaits any man with the will to claim it for his own. Leave Tabor by that path and venture west. The ancient beast roams the fields of Carava, not far from the Tovany Gate.
The bearer of the burning quill is within, my lord. Prithee enter.
Safe.
Yeah.
faster.
You deserve a rest. That's like no chocobo I've ever seen. Something tells me it won't be easily broken.
Come on.
Poor beast. There was nothing I could do. Let's go.
Forsaken soul, eh? Only those who have nothing are looking here. Show them to your pockets.
Let's have some fun!
Good.
Come on. This might take a while. To ride from here.